number 4 par.
Good evening. I'm Mellisa and I'm doing my MBA in ICFEI University and I'm a Christian. There was a question regarding the food. In the Old Testament, it was said that we do not eat pork, but the New Testament, Jesus said that all food are fit to be eaten. So the question arises there.
Behan ne sawal kiya hai ki Old Testament mein likha hai ki suar ka gosht mat khao, lekin Isa alaihi salam ne New Testament mein kaha ki sab khana aap kha sakte. Ye hai Bible. मैं चैलेंज करता हूं आपको दिखाने के लिए बाइबल में कहां कहा है ईसा अलैहि सलाम ने कि सब खाना जायज है. देयर इज समथिंग लाइक अ रेड लेटर बाइबल सिस्टर. एक रेड लेटर बाइबल है जिसका मतलब जो कुछ ईसा अलैहि सलाम ने कहा है वो रेड इंक में लिखा है, लाल लाल रंग से लिखा हुआ है. और अगर आप रेड लेटर बाइबल लेंगे और तहकीक करेंगे, बहुत कम चीज रेड में लिखी है बाइबल में. रेड मतलब ईसाई के स्कॉलर्स कहते हैं ये ईसा अलैहिस्सलाम ने कहा, जो ब्लैक में वो ईसा अलैहिस्सलाम ने नहीं कहा. जो सिस्टर जिक्र कर रही है वो कर रही है सेंट पीटर के बारे में, नॉट जीसस क्राइस्ट. ईसा अलैहिस्सलाम ने कभी भी नहीं कहा कि आप सब कुछ खाओ. एक ख्वाब आता है पीटर को, उस ख्वाब में उसने देखा कि सुअर खाना अच्छी बात है, इसलिए सुअर खाना सही हो गया. ईसा अलैहि सलाम क्या कहते हैं? ईसा अलैहि सलाम कहते हैं न्यू टेस्टामेंट में गॉस्पेल ऑफ मैथ्यू में चैप्टर नंबर 5 वर्स नंबर 17 से 20 तक. जीसस क्राइस्ट पीस बी अपॉन हिम सेज इन द गॉस्पेल ऑफ मैथ्यू चैप्टर नंबर 5 वर्स नंबर 17 टू 20, थिंक नॉट दैट आई हैव कम टू डिस्ट्रॉय द लॉ ऑफ द प्रॉफिट्स. आई हैव कम नॉट टू डिस्ट्रॉय बट टू फुलफिल, एंड नॉट वन जॉट और टिटल शैल पास अवे अंटिल द लॉ बी फुलफिल्ड. एंड एनीवन हु ब्रेक्स वन ऑफ द लीस्ट कमांडमेंट्स shall be called least in the kingdom of heaven, and whosoever shall keep the commandment and teach men to do so shall be called great in the kingdom of heaven. Unless your righteousness exceeds the righteousness of the scribes and the Pharisees, in no way shall you enter the kingdom of heaven. Sister, this is a verbatim quotation from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 5, verse number 17 to 20 of King James Version. I'm speaking from my head, God-given computer. You can check it up. ईसा अलैहि सलाम कहते हैं थिंक नॉट दैट आई हैव कम टू डिस्ट्रॉय द लॉ ऑफ द प्रॉफिट्स. मैं नहीं आया हूं पहले शरीयत को तोड़ने के लिए, नष्ट करने के लिए, लेकिन मैं आया हूं उसको मुकम्मल करने के लिए, उसकी तस्दीक करने के लिए. और अगर आप एक भी नुक्ता पुरानी शरीयत का छोड़ते हैं तो आप जन्नत में कभी नहीं जाएंगे. इवन इफ यू ब्रेक वन जॉट और टिटल यू शैल नॉट enter the kingdom of heaven. Who said that? Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. Ek bhi cheez jo Old Testament mein likhi hai, agar aap usko todte hai, to jannat mein jayenge nahi. Woh to St. Paul aur baaki ke log aaye aur phir badalne ki koshish ki. Out of the New Testament, sister, there are 27 books in the New Testament. More than 50% have been written by St. Paul. St. Paul is a self-appointed apostle of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. He hardly met him. Some scholars say he only met him once. So we have to follow the teachings of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, not of St. Paul. हमें मानना चाहिए ईसा अलैहि सलाम का कहना, सेंट पॉल का नहीं. ईसाइयत के बारे में बात कर रहा हूं मैं, पॉलाइनिटी के बारे में नहीं. सिस्टर, अगर आपको अच्छा ईसाई बनना है तो आपको सुअर का गोश्त नहीं खाना चाहिए. अगर खाएंगे तो जन्नत में नहीं जाएंगे. उसके पहले आपको इबादत करना चाहिए सिर्फ एक खुदा की. मानना चाहिए आखिरी पैगंबर में ईसा अलैहि सलाम ने कहा एक पैगंबर आएंगे जो आपको अच्छी बात समझाएंगे. यू हैव टू बिलीव इन प्रॉफिट मोहम्मद पीस बी अपॉन हिम. इफ यू डोंट बिलीव इन प्रॉफिट मोहम्मद पीस बी अपॉन हिम, यू आर नॉट अ गुड क्रिश्चियन. यू हैव टू फॉलो द लास्ट एंड फाइनल रेवलेशन, दैट इज द ग्लोरियस कुरान, एंड देन ओनली कैन यू एंटर हेवन. होप दैट आंसर्स द क्वेश्चन, सिस्टर.
अगर कोई गैर मुस्लिम बहन हो तो.
गुड इवनिंग डॉक्टर, दिस इज मेलिसा वंस अगेन. विद रिगार्ड्स टू द फूड, आई आस्क्ड यू अबाउट क्रिश्चियनिटी, बट आई वाज नॉट अलाउड टू काउंटर क्वेश्चन बिकॉज द माइक वाज स्विच्ड ऑफ दैट टाइम, सो आई हैड टू वेट इन द टर्न अगेन. It says in Mark 7 and verse 19 that Jesus said all food are fit to be eaten. So I want you to help me out with that. Mark 7 verse 19.
Sister quoted Mark 7 verse 19.
Yeah.
Verse number 19, because it entered not into his heart, but into his belly, and goeth out into the drain, thereby purging out meats. Purging all meats. Where is it mentioned?
That all food are fit to be eaten.
Where is it mentioned? I've got the Bible. Which version are you referring to, sister?
Good News, New Testament.
Good News, New Testament. What does it read? Here I've got the King James Version, which is the most popular of the versions. It says that because it enters not into the heart, but into the belly, and goeth out into the drain, thereby purging all meats.
Yep.
The context, if you read from starting, sister.
We are referring to Good News Bible.
That's right. And when he had entered into the house away from the people, his disciple asked him concerning the parable, and he said unto them, Are ye so without understanding also? Do ye not perceive that whatsoever thing from without enter into man, it cannot defile him? What enters from out cannot defile him. Because it entered not into his heart, but into a belly, and goeth unto into his drain, thereby by purging all meats. And he said, That which cometh out of the man, that defileth the man, from within out of the heart of men, proceed evil thoughts, adulteries, fornication, murders. Sister, it says that what you eat, it doesn't change your heart. That doesn't mean it has given you permission to eat. It says that what you eat, it goes into your belly, and that we know scientifically. It doesn't go into your heart. What you eat, it goes into your belly. But Jesus Christ also said, which I told you earlier, for example, Quran says very clearly, that eat of all the things which is good for you. Quran says like that. So if you pick up the word of Surah Baqarah chapter 2 verse number 168, eat the thing which is good for you. There it doesn't say that pork is haram. So when we read the Quran, we take the Quran as a whole. But in three other places, the Quran says pork is haram. So sister, same way in this Bible, it says what you eat, you can eat. You can eat the meat, but if it is prohibited somewhere else, that becomes a prohibition. You have to read the Bible as a whole. Unfortunately, Christians pick up verses of the Bible and they quote out of context. So this also, sister, I do agree with this verse. But if you go ahead in the Gospel of Matthew, which I quoted to you earlier, Gospel of Matthew chapter number 5, verse number 17, it says, Think not that I have come to destroy the law of the prophets. I have come not to destroy, but to fulfill. Unless the heaven and the earth pass away, not one jot or tittle shall pass away from the law until all be fulfilled. If you break one of the least commandments, you shall not enter heaven. So now you cannot agree that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, has made a contradiction. You can't agree with that. So what do you say? Fine. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said you can eat all lawful things. But what is prohibited in the Old Testament is yet prohibited. That doesn't mean he overrules. If I agree with this work, then I have to say that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, is contradicting himself, which I cannot agree. I believe Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, is a prophet of God. So the sister, the thing is that many people are quoting you Bible out of context. Similarly, the Quran says you can eat all animals. All four-footed animals, but the Quran is more clear with the exception named. So remind the chapter number 5, verse number 1. So the exceptions can either be in the Quran or the Sahih Hadith. Similarly, this verse says that all the things which is lawful you can have. It's no problem. But what has been prohibited in the Old Testament is yet prohibited today, because if you break one law or one dot or one tittle, you shall not enter heaven. Hope that answers the question, sister.
माइक नंबर एक से बराए करम सवाल कर